Throughout their lives, women face a series of blood clotting challenges unique to their gender. Important choices women make about family planning or birth control, pregnancy and childbirth, and the treatment of menopause symptoms later in life all can impact their potential risk for life-threatening blood clots.
Why is this important?
Each year in the United States, about 900,000 people are affected by blood clots. About 100,000 of these people will die. Annually, more people lose their lives due to blood clots than due to breast cancer, AIDS, and automobile accidents combined. Dangerous blood clots often form in the deep veins of a person's arm or leg. This type of blood clot is called a deep vein thrombosis, or DVT. If a DVT is left untreated, it can break off or travel to the lung. A blood clot that travels to the lung is called a pulmonary embolism, or PE, and can be life-threatening. Women are more at risk for blood clots during childbearing age, but they also face unique risks later in life, when the onset of menopause symptoms occur. Pregnancy is a major risk factor for the development of dangerous blood clots and can increase a woman's blood clot risk fourfold. This risk only increases up to 20-fold in the weeks immediately following childbirth. The greatest risk occurs in the first week after the baby is born, when it is as high as 100-fold. This tendency for a woman's body to form clots during pregnancy is the result of a natural response to protect women against the bleeding challenges of miscarriage and childbirth. In general, there are several groups of women who need to be on anticoagulants or blood thinning medication during pregnancy, including women who have had a blood clot and are already taking blood thinning medication, women who have had a blood clot in the past but are not currently taking blood thinning medication, women who develop a blood clot during pregnancy, and after delivery, women who have not had a clot, but who have other major risk factors, such as obesity. There are blood-thinning medications, including standard or unfractionated heparin and low molecular weight heparin, that are safe in pregnancy because they do not cross the placenta or enter the bloodstream of the unborn baby. Low molecular weight heparin is preferred over heparin because it presents fewer side effects. Use of blood-thinning pills like warfarin or the newer oral anticoagulant therapies are commonly prescribed for many people, but they are not considered safe for unborn babies. After delivery, women who have had a blood clot in the past, women who have a clotting disorder, or women who might have other major risk factors need anticoagulation or blood thinner therapy. Also, women can breastfeed while on low molecular weight heparin injections or warfarin, but the safety of newer oral anticoagulants while breastfeeding has not yet been determined. Women should talk to their doctor or healthcare provider about their blood clot risk factors, particularly if they have a family history of blood clots. If you plan to get pregnant or learn that you are pregnant, always let your doctor know right away and discuss your blood clotting risk. It's crucial for women to understand their blood clot risks and also to recognize and seek medical attention if they experience the signs or symptoms of a blood clot. The symptoms of a blood clot in your leg or arm might include swelling, pain, or tenderness not caused by injury, skin that is warm to the touch, redness or discoloration. The symptoms of a blood clot in your lung might include difficulty breathing, chest pain that worsens with a deep breath, coughing up blood. With the information they need to know about blood clots and an understanding about the spectrum of options that are available to them, women can reduce their clotting risk at these different pivotal life stages. They can stop the clot and enjoy fully the happiness that these life stages offer.